Levene's test for equality of variances is a test of whether the variances of two samples or groups are approximately equal or homogeneous. The independent samples t-test assumes that the variances of the sample groups are approximately equal, or that the samples have homogeneity of variance. Let's break down that word homogeneity. The word homo means same. Geneity refers to the genus, or the nature, or the type. So homogeneity means of the same nature. Variance, of course, refers to the variability in each group. Therefore, homogeneity of variance means that the variance in the groups is of the same nature, or that the two groups have the same kind of variability. The variance does not have to be precisely equal, just close enough. So how do you know if the variance is close enough to be called homogeneous or not? We use a test called Levene's test for equality of variance. Levene's test for equality of variance, which I will just call Levene's test, tests whether the variances of two samples are approximately equal. So it tests our assumption of homogeneity of variance. Like any hypothesis test, Levene's test starts with a null hypothesis. In this case, the null hypothesis is that there is no difference between the variance of the first group and the variance of the second group. Unlike a t-test, in which we are testing whether the mean of the experimental group is different than the mean of the control group after a treatment, and we expect, or perhaps even want, those means to be different, with Levene's test, we want the variances to be the same. We would like Levene's test to be non-significant. That is the assumption of the independent samples t-test. The group variances are the same. They do not differ. So we want Levene's test to be non-significant because we do not want the variances to be different. In SPSS, a Levene's test is conducted automatically anytime you do an independent samples t-test. Levene's test is going to be included in the output for that t-test. Levene's test is an F-test, the same kind of test as an ANOVA. So we could interpret the significance value exactly the same as we would for any hypothesis test. Check this box, labeled SIG. If the significance is greater than 0.05, i.e. non-significant, the variances are not significantly different, so equal variances are assumed. Now in this case, the probability is 0.363. The assumption of homogeneity of variance has been met. The variances are equal. They're not different, or at least they're close enough. Since the assumption has been met, we will interpret the t-test using the top line, equal variances assumed. On the other hand, if the significance value is less than 0.05, i.e. it is significant, then the variances are statistically significantly different. So equal variances are not assumed. In this case, the probability equals 0.042. The assumption of homogeneity of variance has been violated. Therefore, we would interpret the t-test on the bottom line, equal variances not assumed. So remember that you, as a researcher, can set the alpha level to the value that is most important to your research. Therefore, many researchers choose to interpret Levene's test using a cutoff significance criteria of 0.01 or even 0.001 instead of 0.05. We want the groups to be really screwy before we start making adjustments to the tests. Using a more restrictive alpha level, like 0.001, for testing assumptions would be especially useful when you have a large sample size for your t-test. Any hypothesis test is more likely to be statistically significant when you have a large sample size, including the Levene's test. Now you should remember that as long as your total sample size is greater than 30, and the sample size in the first sample is approximately equal to the sample size of the second sample, then the t-test is robust to violations of homogeneity of variance. As I mentioned, a Levene's test will be automatically included in the output anytime you do an independent samples t-test. I'm going to show you how to do the t-test in the next video, but I want to show you that you can do a Levene's test in SPSS anytime you like. I am using the job satisfaction dataset that I will use for correlation and regression. We are going to do a Levene's test on job satisfaction between men and women. Go to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, Explore. Move job satisfaction into the dependents list and gender into the factor list. This will create two groups based on gender for the job satisfaction variable. This time, we are going to turn off some of the default output. Click on Plots. Turn off the box plots and uncheck stem and leaf. Under Spread versus Level with Levene's test, choose Untransformed. Click Continue and OK. Now, most of this output we will not need. Scroll down until you find Levene's test. We are interested in the test based on the mean, which we can see is non-significant, p equals 0.822. The variances are equal, or at least close enough. To make sure that this is working, let's do an independent samples t-test. Go to Analyze, Compare Means, Independent Samples T-Test. Move job satisfaction into the test variables box and gender into grouping variables. Click on Define Groups and define the groups as 1 and 2 for male and female. Click Continue and OK. In the output, notice that we have two sections. Now remember, anytime we have a group of numbers, we can calculate a mean and a standard deviation, or variance. What SPSS has given us are two types of hypothesis tests. These are the results for a test of equality of variances. This is Levene's test, and we would like the variances to be the same, or homogeneous. These are the results for the test for equality of means. This is the t-test, which typically we would prefer to be different, indicating that our intervention worked. The Levene's test f-value was 0.051, with a significance, or p-value, of 0.822. Again, non-significant, so the variances can be assumed to be equal. Now let's check our previous output. Scroll up, and you will see that the Levene statistic based on the mean was 0.051 with a significance of 0.822, exactly the same. Although here, we are given the degrees of freedom for the F-test, 1 and 198. Now scroll back down. Although we are not given the degrees of freedom with the t-test output, we can figure them out pretty easily. The degrees of freedom between is always 1, because the t-test only compares two groups. The degrees of freedom within is the same as the degrees of freedom for the t-test itself, 198. We would write up the Levene statistic as F with 1 and 198 degrees of freedom equals 0.051, p equals 0.822.